At the beginning of the year, you talked about some exciting developments at MacArthur Airport. Does the Senate budget include any of that for the redevelopment?
Yes, we have funds available for creating a customs facility at Islip Air MacArthur Airport. The governor, to his credit, put $6 million into the state budget. The Senate approved that. The Assembly has not approved it yet, so it's not soup yet. We're hoping to have it in the final version of it. But it would be a big boon for the Islip Airport. It would allow them to bring flights in from Europe and not have to screen them at the other end. We've never done that. Islip has never been an international airport. And for those people who live around the airport are concerned about these big jets, that's not what we're talking about. Because of the changes in technology for planes, they're not going to be bigger, they're not going to be louder, but they're going to be able to make the cross-country, cross-ocean trip and land at Islip and then not have to go into Kennedy and MacArthur to go to Europe.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be exciting.
Last week during session, you recognized the 40th anniversary of New York Aviation Management Association. Let's watch that.
As many of you know, we have an aviation caucus here in the state legislature. There are 42 state senators who are members of that caucus, and we work to promote the aviation industry in New York State. The Aviation Management Association is a key player in that regard. It has been the voice of aviation in New York State. Just a couple quick statistics about our aviation industry in New York State. New York's aviation industry is responsible for over $50 billion in annual economic activity here in the state of New York. It's responsible for $2.8 billion in state and local taxes generated from the aviation industry. And it's over 400,000 jobs, directly and indirectly, associated with the aviation industry. Compared to the entire United States, New York State makes up 7% of the aviation activity economically in the entire country. Aviation is a major player, and all of us, if we don't have airports or aviation workers in our districts, we have them nearby. Some big ones downstate, medium-sized, regional, small ones, whatever the case may be, it is a vital industry, and we want to thank and congratulate the New York Aviation Aviation Managers Association for its 40th anniversary. Keep up the good work, being the voice of aviation.
So you're the Senate Chairman of the Aviation Caucus.
I am, yes. And my colleague, Assemblywoman Donna Lepardo from Binghamton, is the Assembly Chairperson. We gather a lot of new members. It had been a little dormant over the last few years, the Aviation Caucus, but we had a tremendous win last year, Julia, in the creation, in the passage of the Aviation Jobs Act. Viewers might have read it about it saying, oh, it was a tax break for millionaires with their planes and stuff like that, but we argued that that was not the case at all. The fact is that people, companies and rich people who had private planes were keeping them in Connecticut and Massachusetts and not keeping them here in New York State. We lost in the span of 10 years when we increased taxes on the use, on the maintenance taxes and the use taxes of planes in the airports, we lost 700 planes that used to be kept in New York State were moving to other states. Now, each of those planes is five jobs, security, maintenance, all these other things going on. The great news, and we've read several articles about it and talked to aviation managers, like airport managers, that since we passed that bill last year, more planes are coming back. One company is building three hangars on Long Island for new planes, and there's other ones being built upstate. Again, with maintenance jobs and security jobs for each plane, we're going to talk about a real significant change in the aviation industry. It's started out good. It's going to get even better now with the state budget. We're including money for airports. The governor's had some in his proposal, his budget proposal. The state senate's going to add to it to give infrastructure, longer runways, more buildings and stuff like that. So it's all signs are pointing up for the aviation industry in New York State.